Hello, in this video, I am planning at this moment in time, it's gonna happen though. I'm planning to talk about the JavaScript functions. These are JavaScript, native to the browser JavaScript functions, set timeout and set interval. I will be looking at how to use these functions in the context of a JavaScript framework called P5, but really the focus is these particular functions, set timeout and set interval. What are these functions? How do they work? What's the syntax for using them? And why might you use them at all? So let's begin right now. So first let me come over here to the whiteboard, and I'm just gonna take a moment to meditate and breathe, and then write the words on the whiteboard here, set time out. This is a function in JavaScript that accepts two arguments. You are asked to put two arguments inside this function. The first argument is another function. Now, if you've watched any of my videos before, which maybe you have or maybe you haven't, or if you've done any JavaScript programming before, this idea of passing a function as an argument to another function isn't a new thing. This is very common. Functions are in JavaScript are just variables or just things that you can declare, that you can execute, and that you can pass around as functions. So what needs to go in here is a function. For example, I'm going to call this function rainbow. So the function is called rainbow, and it might have some code in it, which means setTimeout should reference that function. That's the first argument. I want to setTimeout the rainbow function. The second argument is time, a moment of time in milliseconds. What does milliseconds mean? 1 second equals 1,000 milliseconds. Milli is being for 1,000. I think somewhere in Latin or something it comes from that, probably. So if you want something, if you want to reference 1 minute, you would be saying 60 seconds or 60,000 milliseconds. So time goes in here. So for example, if I put 2,000 here as my second argument, that means 2 seconds. So set timeout, the rainbow function, 2,000. What does that mean? It means I want the code that's inside the rainbow function to execute 2 seconds from now. This is just a marvelous, you know, this is like the gestalt of everything that happens in JavaScript. It's, you know, it's callbacks and asynchronous things. I have this block of code, I'm gonna specify when it should happen, and then somehow it will just happen then based on what I specified. So this really like represents everything there is to be about the programming language JavaScript all here. Now I should briefly mention before I start writing this code and making something happen in the actual code that this is often not written this way. This is often written as what's called an anonymous function. So right, I said set timeout requires two arguments, a function like this function rainbow and a time when that function should be executed, like 2,000 milliseconds or 2 seconds later from when this function was called. However, you could actually take all of the code that's here and just stick it right in where this is. And I'll demonstrate that to you when I type stuff out. For teaching and kind of legibility, I find right now, I find it often useful to break out the function definition into a separate place. Sometimes that's actually necessary depending on what you're doing code-wise, but in many cases it's often convenient, especially if this function is just one line of code, to embed it anonymously in here. What do I mean by anonymous, by the way? Like, why would a function be anonymous? So what I mean by that is this function's name is rainbow, and we need the function's name so that setTimeout can refer to that particular function. But if we define the function right in here, it wouldn't actually need a name because we don't need to reference it. We're just sticking it in there. So you could write in here an anonymous function would look like this. Can you see that? Hopefully you can see that. So this entire block of code with something written in here to actually do could be inserted right there. So sorry, it's a little bit long-winded, but this is the basic idea of set timeout. So now, here we are. Here I am at least, and maybe you're still watching, or maybe you've gone and watched a Stampy Cat and a Minecraft video instead. We're totally bored by me. But, never mind. I was going to think of some other interesting things you could watch on YouTube, but I guess you have your own interests separate from mine. Not that that's one of my interests, but putting that all aside, what do I have over here? So what I have over here is a JavaScript program. It's a P5 sketch. It has some code written to it already. So if you're familiar with P5, there's a setup function, there's a draw function. Setup is where I'm creating a canvas that appears in the browser, and draw is this thing that's just automatically happening over and over again. So there already is a sense of time in this particular example, and time is managed for us, for me, by the P5 library. But I want to do something different. So what you might have sometimes seen in processing programs or P5JS programs or any kind of program that anyone's ever written in the history of programming in the universe is like an if statement in here. If a certain number of milliseconds has passed or if the number of frames that have been animated, then do this. So this using set timeout is a way that I could say, you know what? I want something to happen 5 seconds after the program starts without having to check inside of draw, when is this, how many times through draw, what time is it, that sort of thing. So let's look at how, let's come up with something. So I'm going to write my function called rainbow. I don't know why I put the bow at capital B. And in that function, I'm just going to say create P rainbow. So my non-existent colorful rainbow is going to be replaced by just a paragraph of text with the word rainbow in it. So you can see right here, if I were to just execute that function in setup and run the code again, you can see in addition to the canvas, I now have the paragraph rainbow. The rainbow function was called right when the program start and the paragraph was created. So now, let me say instead, set timeout rainbow, and then I'm gonna say 3,000. Whoops, 3,000. So I'm gonna say for 3,000 milliseconds later, or 3 seconds later, create that paragraph. This is going to be very exciting. Here we go. Are you ready? Ready to count? 1,000, 2,000, 3,000. There we go. See? So 3,000 milliseconds later, that code gets executed. So you could imagine if you want to script a whole bunch of things to happen at various points of time, you can make that happen. Now, this isn't to say that this has to just happen in setup. For example, what I can do now is I could, you know, add the generic, I probably should make a button or something, but I'll just add the generic kind of global mouse press function. So anywhere I click the mouse on the page, right? I could count to 3 all I want, but I'm not going to get my rainbow until I click the mouse. But when I click the mouse, I'm not going to get the rainbow until... That was so perfect timing. And now I'm going to do it again. Oh, shoot, I'm so close. Okay, you get the idea though, right? So this is what set timeout does. It allows you to trigger a particular action at a given moment in time. And interestingly enough, I could do something like if I called this in the rainbow function, let's see what happens here. I'm gonna put this back in setup. And I'm going to make this 1,000. And I'm going to run this again. Rainbow, 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 rainbow. Right? Every second I get a new rainbow. You get a rainbow. You get a rainbow. You get a rainbow. You get a rainbow. Everybody gets a rainbow. So I've really got to stop this video now that I've started acting like Oprah. But so anyway, so that's the point. I think you get it. I think this was good. It's almost like too easy. There's not very much here. I'm so used to like wanting to make a 5-minute video and it takes 15 minutes that I made this way too long and I'm only at 8 minutes. So there's more to this than that. There's more to it than this. So I've shown you the very basics. What I want to do, I'll make a couple more videos. One, I'll show you set interval, which actually will do something much like this, where I've sort of nested the call to set timeout every 1,000 milliseconds. And then I want to look at what happens if you want to create different sequences of things happening. Like, what if you, here's a scenario that I think would be worth looking at. What if you had an array of musical notes and you wanted those notes to play in a sequence, each one of those notes with a certain amount of time essentially to play a melody? How might you do that with set timeout to specifying the time for each one of those notes? So I'm hoping to make a video with an example like that. Okay, thanks very much, and I'm gonna hit stop now.